is this incredible art conversation. Please come on, take your seats. We're going to start our next panel discussion. Can everybody take their seats, please? Okay, great, because we're going to start this amazing discussion. The first thing I wanted to say, by the way, is once again, before we start our first art conversation of the day, I just want to urge people again, during the next break, take a look at the paintings that are emerging on our windows outside. These incredible emerging Chinese artists. There's Sam Nandan, who's over here on the right side, and Jia Yun is painting on that side. So please go take a look at it when we take our next break. So everybody, we are so, so thrilled now to welcome an amazingly talented and renowned artist. Li Jin, who's sitting here. Exactly. He's an amazing, amazing artist. And you will find his work in the Metropolitan Museum's collection. And Li Jin is widely considered to be the most important contemporary Chinese artist using traditional Chinese brush technique. He also happens to be a gourmand who loves eating Chinese food. So it's a perfect combination of food and art. He is joined in conversation by an equally brilliant China expert, the art historian and documentary filmmaker, Carma Hinton. So thank you so much, both of you, for joining us. Over to you. We're going to have a conversation. Li Jin is first going to show us some of his works for anybody who doesn't know what his work looks like, and then they're going to have a conversation. Thanks.
Are we on? People can hear? Can you hear me? Not yet? Can you hear me? Okay. Oh, very close. Okay. Okay, now it's good? All right. So we're going to begin. I'm basically here to facilitate Li Jin to tell you all about his art, and I will translate for him. We'll have a conversation, and occasionally, if you have a question, we can also entertain that. He will begin to run through some of his slides, and then we'll take it from there. Is it not? I can't hear? Speak louder. Well, sometimes when you speak louder, there's a lot of popping of the mic. Oh, really? Okay, that's good. Yeah, I don't want the people to feel kind of harassed with the popping of the mic. Okay, 那就由你先开始，然后我来给你翻译。 I don't think anybody needs to translate from English into Chinese, right?
我先放一点那个幻灯片，因为这个前面讲了，基本上没有利用这个图像这一块，我是画画了，我还是先让大家先，因为我毕竟是靠这个图像和视觉表达自己的想法的人，所以呢，先放一点我的作品的图片。I'll
begin showing some of my paintings. On the previous panels, there were no images. As I'm an artist, I use imagery to express my thoughts. So I will begin my first show and then tell.
我这次来纽约参加这个活动，很重要一点就是因为我知道这个活动跟美食有关，这个是我无论是在生活中我喜欢吃，还是在我创作中喜欢画，都是因为美食，所以这个活动对我是有诱惑的，我不管事情多忙，还是会过来跟大家分享和交流。
The reason why I came so far away from China, especially for this event, is because it's about cuisine, it's about food. And I am an artist who loves to eat and love food. And so this topic is very enticing to me. So I'm here in New York to participate in this activity. 我先翻译一下你上面的那个字吧。
Right, with the meat there, the inscription says that those who eat meat should be despised.
<音><音>这一组作品就是我现在实际上带来的这个幻冬天呢。 是按我的创作风格和年代那么排序的，这一组作品是我80年代，我85年的时候，在西藏大学教书，在拉萨创作的，这就是我毕业以后，开始更加就是追求一种个人语言，追求个人的风格的一个开端，这个开端实际上是在。 西藏开始的。
These slides are arranged in chronological order, and this set here, they were painted in 1985 after I graduated from art school. I taught in Tibet, and that was the beginning of my searching for my own personal style and expression. All of these are painted in
对，都是在西藏的作品。
All of these are painted in Tibet.
这个时候呢，我就从西藏回来。回来以后呢，实际上我关心的题材更接近我自己的生活，而且呢，在城市里头，去寻找趣味。 无论是吃的趣味、画的趣味，还有自己平时这个生活的趣味，这个时候我有变化了，不像在西藏，这么想的问题，这个天高地厚了。After
I returned to my own city, I was surrounded by city life, daily life, and I began to really pay attention to what's around me. Art no longer engages in some faraway ideas and faraway place.
This时候的作品呢，可以说，我们讲就是调侃，有点调侃。Yes,
these works are kind of fun and making fun, kind of.
Paintings。从题材上呢，应该讲就是说，在传统绘画里头，因为我是画中国画的，在传统绘画里用传统笔墨语言表现，这个题材反正我自己没有见过，就是古人画过这个题材，也就是说这个题材可能在过去是属于。
This is a kind of painting, it is unfound in traditional Chinese. The subject is unfound from any Chinese traditional painting. I'm a Chinese artist who uses traditional Chinese techniques, but I painted things that were normally considered not deeming to be worthy of entering the Hall of Art. These paintings show sort of nostalgic feelings and also making fun of myself.
这个作品呢，我要特别提一下，就是为什么我选了好多这个作品，就是我在这个作品是我在美国画的，而且当时画的理由是，波士顿美术馆举办了一个鱼骨为图的这么一个展览，这个展览呢对我来说也很重要。其实很多后来很多美国人。 或者说更多国家的人知道我也是因为这个展览。
These paintings were painted in Boston. It was on the occasion of an exhibition that invited Chinese artists to respond to great works of traditional Chinese art that's in the collection of the museum, Boston Museum of Fine Arts. So I took part in this, and one of the reasons that I became more widely known in the West is also because of this particular exhibition in Boston.
这里头呢，实际上是我根据一幅古画改的。当时就是我选择古画的时候，我还是考虑到就是跟我兴趣点和我的这个能力，所以我选的叫北极交通图。
I selected a painting that more attuned to my own sensibilities, and it was a Northern Qi scholars collating classical writings. And I responded to that painting and invented my own painting in response to that particular painting. That was painted 900 years ago. I'm adding that footnote.
那幅作品，就是北极交通图这幅作品，是画了好多这个文人雅士，这个有他们自己的这种所谓的，我们说通俗点就是吃喝玩乐的一个场景。
This particular painting that I responded to focused on the life of the literati. There is an elegant literary men. If you put it in some more simple terms, it's about their eat, drink, enjoyment, and all that in their life.
里边呢有也关，里边也表现了好多吃，也表现了一些宴，就是宴请的东西。我的画里头实际上就是说，是别人给我概括，就说我画的基本就可以用这个饮食男女来形容我的作品的主题。我呢也接受这个评论。
That painting also has certain erotic overtones, and some people have talked about my painting as basically man, woman, eat, drink, man, woman. So. I think I could accept that description of my art.
就是说所谓的这种生动，我认为，因为我的创作理念是想，我的作品首先我要让人感觉到这个东西是有生命的，是活的，是生动的。
My main goal is to capture life the way life is vital.I want to show something that's really alive.
并且这作品里头能折射出来一种我对，比如说对美食、对女人的这种从心里的一种热爱。
And my painting, I wanted to express through my paintings the love I have for good food and for language.
然后呢，通过自己的这种能力。就是绘画的能力，能够尽量去感染别人，并且我希望我的画里头，就是它应该给别人有一种亲近感，就有一种的门槛不是很高，会被它吸引。
I want my paintings to transmit what I feel about these things onto the audience, and I wanted.These paintings to be intimate, so that people can engage with them on a very personal level.
Actually, 就是别人在欣赏绘画的时候，每个人的角度和自己的直觉判断就足以了。我并不需要别人去非要解读我最开始的想法，而是你看到的东西，你看到哪一部分，按你自己的判断和 和理解，或者说是接受，或者是拒绝，都可以。这个就是绘画本身的一个感觉的东西。
Actually, I don't need to explain too much about my paintings, because that is an expression. Though they are expressions through imagery, and there's not a whole lot that need to be explained. I think the paintings themselves communicate something directly to the viewer, and you can look at the paintings and take away something from the paintings. You can either enjoy them or reject them or whatever, and each in the audience will have a different reaction. So he's going to stop the talking, reduce the talking, and just let you take a look at the painting.
过去用水墨表现这个题材也没有多少人去尝试，我自己呢也是第一次，就是说我先不要考虑我是干什么，我是要把我看到的表现出来。
This is what I saw in New York when I first came here. St. Patrick's Day and very rally parades and so on. I was very excited, and so I thought I'd like to actually express my feeling about the excitement. I've never tried to paint anything from the outside world in Chinese traditional techniques, and I wanted to just express my own excitement in seeing these views.
这里头有一个小，就是有一个很有趣的事儿，我要说一下。就是我呢，画这个题材的时候，因为我在美国，所以呢，我犯了一个大忌，在如果在中国的话，犯了一个大忌，就是男的不能戴绿帽子。
And there's one little episode here that is worth noting, that in China there is a taboo against men wearing green hats. And since the St. Patrick's Day, everybody was wearing green, and I painted them that way, and that didn't go over very well with some Chinese.
这个我不知道，这个应该都知道绿帽子的概念，你得说一下。
I'm not sure. Well, in there's this idea in China that if somebody's wife had an affair with somebody else, then it is described to the man that this man is wearing a green hat. So it's sort of, I don't know the history of where this particular metaphor came from, but it's, if you see a man with a green hat, it's almost like this is a comment on this person's married life.
然后呢，有一个确实因为这件事还是比较严重，在什么地方呢？就有一个收藏家买了我一张，这类的作品，但是这个收藏家是中国人，但是他在美国买的，然后回来跟我联系，很郑重地求我把帽子颜色改过来。
There was a collector who bought one of these paintings, and he bought it in America, and he brought it back to China, and he contacted me and pleaded with me to change the color of that hat in his own personal painting that he bought.
我呢是作为艺术家，我挺有原则的，我从来不会给别人按收藏家的意愿去改什么，但是这次例外，因为我真怕影响他的生活，我也担不起这责任。
normally, I'm a very principled artist. I'm not going to be swayed by other people's demands on my art. But this particular place, in this particular case, I made an exception because I felt kind of responsible for his private life.
这个是我的一个在北京做的一个个展，就是这个展览是以吃为主题的，这个展览呢，我们现在看这个场景，实际上是我也是故意做那么一个场景。简单讲一下这个展览是什么呢？就是我是两个大的展厅，一个展厅我是展了一幅长条的作品。 跟做了一张像我们吃饭一样的一个普通高度的桌子，20多米的一个桌子，然后在这个桌子上铺着我的画，其实当时我的想法就是说，你看这个展览就像你吃晚餐一样，就是一个视觉的晚宴，我画了很多很多的佳肴，这是一个视觉，所谓精神上的享受，对食品的享受。
This is a scene of an exhibition of mine that the whole setup was to have people directly experience visually and otherwise a kind of an enjoyment of the spirit.
然后第二个展厅就是我真的摆了这么一桌，有食物，有烤猪，有这个蛋糕，有鲜花。 然后我请了两个团队，一个团队就是大董，大董烤鸭，做中国最有名的大董，大董都知道，大董现在可能都开到美国来了，我估计，就是一个做中餐的经典的餐馆，一个呢我请了一个团队是做西餐的，威斯汀酒店的西餐团队，同时在这个。 第二展厅里做饭。So
the first exhibition hall, I laid out on dining table, you know, some setup like that, many of my paintings. And then in the second exhibition hall, I set up a scene of a banquet with both Chinese and Western food, the Chinese food. I invited a very famous Peking duck. Peking duck restaurant, and then also a Western food restaurant to set up a real banquet.
这样的话呢，实际上我也是想表达一个理念，一个是今天的这个东西文化，包括艺术，包括饮食，是在这个时代是必须碰在一起的，必须要给很多。 食客也好，欣赏者也好，都有很多选择的机会。
And through this, I wanted to express the idea that in this world of ours, the East and the West are mingling and meeting, and that there are many choices in the world, and we have to engage.
这两幅作品，上面那幅作品。
The top painting is now part of the collection of the Metropolitan Museum of Art in New York.
我自己觉得他们还是很有眼光。
I thought they had good taste.
至少就是我自己关注的，都这个关注的热点都在这幅画上。
This painting includes just about all of my kind of interest points.
这个是那个另外一种感觉的东西。你看到前边非常热闹，非常有色彩，非常的那种丰盛。这两个画是另外的一个，首先不荤，这是素材。 再有一个又是黑白，其实我还想告诉大家，就是说，实际上，我内心里头，我一直说我自己表面是荤的，我内心实际上很素。
Okay, so here's a whole different style. It's in black and white, and these things are vegetables. So it's not, in Chinese, there's the idea of the hun and the su, meaning the vegetarian or meat. But hun also sort of mean, has a further inference of meaning, meaning eroticism, sex, and so on. So he says, on the surface, I appear very hun, meaning meat, erotic, all of that in my paintings. But actually, down deep in my heart, I'm rather vegetarian, rather su. But su can also infer in meaning to be some kind of calm, kind of bland, simple, all of that. So the two that the words that describe food, literally meaning vegetarian or meat eating, in that extends a lot in cultural meaning. So this is a really singing praises of beautiful, lovely food.
我后面好多文字呢，也根据不同的那种状态在写的文字内容。我最早写过写的文字的时候，用了很多这个菜谱，抄了很多菜谱，就是告诉这些美食的制作过程，同时也告诉他的在这个过程里也有好多挺恐怖的感觉，比如说你把这个鱼头怎么砍下来，把五脏怎么掏出来。 这个过程实际上，如果真的落实在文字上，或者落实在画面里，都会使大家很不舒服。
These are delicious dishes, and the inscription I included a lot of specific recipes and processes of how food, how these dishes are made, and actually some of it is a bit horrifying, like how to chop off the fish's head, rather literally. Graphic and how to cut the fish open and take out his intestines and so on. So it's when I put these kinds of descriptions in the inscription, it had, you know, you can see the delicious food, but there's also a side that's a little ominous.
有时候会在后面抄上好多唐诗。 因为我感觉就是过去这个很多诗人的语句都是在饭桌上，都是在酒桌上出来的，所以呢，我又会把那种很浪漫的一种东西放在背后。Other
inscriptions include a lot of Tang Dynasty poetry because so many of these poets they compose their best work with wine and food. So it's very pertinent that these inscriptions would include the great poets of the Tang Dynasty. So now that you saw the paintings, we can begin with a little conversation about, first I want to ask him how he grew up in a brief childhood experience.
先问你就是小时候的一些经历，简单点。就是简单说啊，就是首先，我记得我好像就是很三岁吧就开始画画了，就是等于绘画对我来说是一个肯定是天生的兴趣。So
I remember starting at 3 years old, I started painting, and painting seems to be a born interest of mine. 你是先喜欢吃的还是先喜欢画的? I'm asking him, did he first love painting or did he first love eating?
肯定是先喜欢吃，这是肯定的。因为我如果说我自己最后动了想画食品的概念，也是因为我太爱吃了，觉得我不把我的这种能力，把我这种喜好表现给别人的话。 我觉得我有点不太称职当画家。
Yeah, definitely I loved eating first, and I love eating so much that if I didn't express this love through my paintings to people, then I would have not been worthy of being an artist.
而且呢，后来我想过，就是我后来那么多的热情，大量的画这种所谓丰盛佳肴啊，还是跟我可能我因为我们小的时候物质没那么好。
One other reason why I paint such luscious banquets and luscious food is partly probably has to do with when I grew up, we didn't have very much food.
有那种，有一种这种。欠缺呀、啊，饥饿、啊，有这种一种痕，心里有那么一种痕迹。一旦这个情况好了，经济好了，肯定有很就第一需要就是先满足食欲。
So there is this shadow of my childhood of the lack of food and of want. So that as soon as the economy got better, the very first thing that I became interested in, of course, is to satisfy the food urges.
这个肯定，我到我儿子那一代已经跟我有区别了。
My son is different, and he belongs to another generation.
前面先说一遍。
另外一个问题就是你的画的风格。How he uses Chinese, basically, you know, painting is hard to classify, but maybe if we generally classify his painting, can be seen as he is using traditional Chinese techniques. So I'm asking him about how that came about, how he started.
这个问题挺好问的，因为。我是在美术学院学的专业就是中国画专业。所谓中国画专业，实际上就是，主要是学传统绘画。
When I was in art school, I studied in the Chinese art department, and most of it has to do with learning the traditional techniques of Chinese painting.
我的老师有好多。属于当时的已经是属于这种老先生啊，或者是很国宝级的老先生都有。
Among my teachers, there are Chinese painters that could be classified as national treasures.
但是呢，实际上，就是我后来才正式的越来越感觉到，就是我当时上学的时候这些。教传统的老师，虽然我当时不太喜欢学这种课，回过头来一想，就是即使不是很喜欢，但是已经足够影响我一生的好多东西。
At the time, I didn't really appreciate it. I wasn't that interested, but I became more and more interested, and I think that training influenced my entire life.
最主要的原因还是这样，为什么不喜欢？一个是我觉得。就是过去的很多传统的画的生存条件已经跟今天不一样了。
One reason that I wasn't that interested in traditional Chinese painting was that the life that is shown through these paintings, the conditions have changed. It's no longer what we live now.
就是我们可能就是。面对这个自己活的这种当下的这种社会和社会的这种形态，已经和过去不一样
了。We live in the very different conditions.
所以后来我就觉得，就是说，如果我尊重我的生活，尊重我的直觉的时候，我认为传统从某种程度更多的是一种技术语言、技巧语言。
So I thought about it, and if I really want to respect my own experience and my own life, what do I get from the tradition is basically the techniques and the language of artistic expression, but I needed to portray my own life.
而且这种语言你继承的这些东西可能在中国有几千年的这种积累。
The artistic language in China has several thousand years of accumulation of experience.
所以它的语言的门槛和成熟度都是非常高的。
So it's very mature artistic language, and it's I guess you can say that it's a very high threshold to reach in order to really get in there and be good at it.
我越到这个美国来，我看大都会，看了那么多美术馆，我越感觉到我过去所学的这种所谓水墨也好，中国画也好，这种语言的方式。 应该是我自己的很有发言权和很有优势的一个地方。
Okay, so I've seen so many great paintings in the museums around the world, in such as the Metropolitan Museum here, and I've become much more appreciative of the traditional Chinese artistic language, and I feel that I really have the right and the heritage to kind of inherit that and to invent beyond that. Okay, we can end here, thank you.
Wow, wow. What an amazing thing to have this incredible artist and this wonderful art historian to help us bring the contents. And to the sweep of history, from the study of traditional Chinese art to his contemporary work, is just incredible. So thank you so, so much. Everybody, we're going to take another 10-minute break, and then we're going to stay for our last panel, which is going to be absolutely incredible. We've got some of China's cutting-edge, leading designers and architects, and they're moderated by Paola Antonelli, who's a visionary curator of design from MoMA. So please stay. While during the break, please take a look again at the paintings that are kind of emerging on the windows. They're so beautiful. We've got Sam on the right side and Jia Yun on the left side. So see you again in 10 minutes. Thank you.